What's up, guys? Eric Weitner here with the Knox Fox Real Estate Group. And today I have a special guest. I have the Knox Fox in the house, Terry Jo Fox.
Hello, everyone.
Well, first of all, I want to just start off by saying, you know, Happy New Year's. It's January is almost over, and this month is just flying by.
It has. This Friday is the 31st, which is also Eric's birthday.
Whoa. Yeah, getting old every minute. So anyways, just kick it off, like, we're a month into the year, and obviously it's flying by, but we all start off the year with big goals. I know Terry, Jill, and I, we started off with some health, fitness goals.
Yeah.
Obviously, we got some business goals, and, you know, travel goals.
Yeah, for the conferences that are for National Association of Realtors, as well as the Tennessee Association of Realtors. We plan to go to quite a few of them to learn and to educate ourselves so that we know what's going on with our current market, our state market, as well as our national market. So we plan to definitely share some things throughout the year with all of you so that you are just informed.
Yeah, big thing about bringing stuff from other places back to Knoxville. So that'll be definitely helpful. But with that being said, too, we also want to know, like, what are your goals this year? You know, are you, you got, you know, big job goals or vacation goals, or, hey, do you have house goals? You know, wink, wink. but, you know, a lot of people, they want to do like remodel stuff, you know, they're really thinking this year, you know, want to do an addition or something. And so what do we always tell people when they want to do stuff to their house? What should they do first?
You should always call us, because we have made some very good relationships that we can refer you some very good contractors, whether it be contractors, plumbers, electricians, HVAC, anything and everything to do with your house. But we also do have a network of variety of different people and professionals outside of the house industry as well.
And also, it's a good idea to have the conversation of why you're doing it. You know, if at the end of the day, you feel like it's going to add value to the property, which a lot of things will. But that's a conversation we should have too, because if you're wanting to do a big remodel and sell it next year, you may not get as much as you think, or, you know, it's just a good conversation to have. And we're always open to it, no matter what. So one thing everybody always wants to know is, like, how's the market? And seeing as how we're continuously helping people buy and sell houses, we'd like to kind of give our feedback. What are you seeing in the marketplace?
So I've been out showing buyers a lot this month. Of course, last month as well, but, you know, fresh new year, kind of just talking about that. A lot of buyers in this market right now. I will tell you, we have a strong market, but it really is going to depend on what price range we're at. So if you have anything that's, I like to go up to about 300,000 and under, and it's priced well, shows well, and has some good, strong marketing like we do here at the Knox Fox, then it's going to sell, I would say, fairly quickly. If you go higher than that, it may sit for a little while, but we still see some things kind of coming off the market and going pending within a few days. But again, it's just going to depend on the area, the floor plan of the house, you know, the condition of it. And so, then as well as new construction, because, you know, if you are competing against new construction just a mile up the road from you, then that is probably going to be, is going to affect you, because it is part of our market conditions.
So really it's very individual,
yes.
Like everybody's situation. I know as a whole, we even throw out stats. We get stats from across the country and in Knoxville, but honestly, every house can be very different in every person's situation. I know working with buyers, when buyers are looking in the, you know, the more affordable price ranges, there's a lot of competition for those homes when they hit the market. So you have to really have a good game plan, a good way to attack that. And same on the sell side, you know, if you feel like it's gonna, you know, we put on the market and we put one on the market, what, over a week ago, on a Friday, and we had multiple offers over the weekend. And in that scenario, it wasn't a highest and best scenario. We just basically, we worked with the best offer.
We did work with the best offer. Sometimes, of course, you know, most of us look at pricing. I mean, I do when I go and shop for something, I want to get the best price possible. But it's not necessarily about getting the best price. You have to look, well, excuse us, rascals here. but you have to look at all the terms within the contract, from the closing date to, the, of course, the closing cost, what we think it might appraise for,
Well, yeah. I was going to say the financing and stuff.
Financing,
like, I mean, there's just a lot of factors that we weigh through to help come up with that. But that house got a lot of attention really quick. Other houses might take a little bit longer. So that's obviously something we're going. You mentioned new construction.
Yes, let's go back to new construction, because I will tell you that in certain areas, you have still lots of new construction. They may not be ready right away, which, say hello.
We've got Rascal in the house now.
Wearing his little fox outfit. So, but going back to the new construction, we have new construction spread out all over East Tennessee. Depending on where you want to be, it could actually, you know, end up being a great situation for you. And so, but I just put a new construction under contract this week, and it was under $200,000. $200,000 for brand new construction. I want to say it was around 2,000 square feet, all the appliances included, including the blinds and the refrigerator and the washer and dryer. I mean,
so pretty awesome deal.
Yeah. And I will tell you that's that client of ours. She is just thrilled to death that she got new construction, because she was looking at, you know, some very old houses that could possibly have some structural issues. And she just loved the style of the cute older bungalow. But I will tell you that seeing her face and, like, her knowing that she can have a new construction house was very rewarding for me and my heart.
So that's pretty cool. And, you know, one thing a lot of people don't think about is when it comes to new construction, is that something we absolutely can help you with, help you in getting it under contract and working with you to getting it to close. And we're your representative, where the agent at the new construction, you know, at that house, or, you know, the open house, or whatever, they represent the seller. They typically work directly for the seller. And there are a lot of great agents. We've worked with quite a few of them over the years, mm-hmm. a lot of great agents, but they still work for the builder. That's their bread and butter. So you definitely want somebody looking out for your best interest when it comes to new construction. And that's exactly what we do. Matter of fact, we own a new construction house, so we very much understand the process.
We do indeed. And going back to just that a little bit is, we have worked with a lot of the builders in our area. So we know their processes. I've built strong relationships with a lot of their sales realtors. So don't ever be afraid to ask any questions about any process, any builder, in anywhere in our East Tennessee area.
So, and along with that, like, obviously we're still helping people, like, buy and sell regular homes. We were just out today, got a new listing coming on the market here soon. We were just out for the photography, met the photographer out there, making sure the lights were on, the windows were open. But this is a cool listing coming up in Maryville, up in the mountains, 6+ acres, 2-bedroom, 2.5-bath.
Approximately 1,700 to 1,800 square feet. It's really, I think it's going to, you know, go on the market and get a lot of activity. But yeah, it's definitely a good looking house, but that's a, you know, going, because Eric mentioned the photographer, that's one of the services that we actually do provide, is that if you are getting your house ready for the market, we don't expect you to do that by yourself. I will come in, Eric and I both do come in, but I come in and I will move things around in your house, make it look like a buyer through a buyer's eyes.
Stage it.
Yes. I don't do the staging like, you know, like a stager, but I do go through and make it, because I'm out in the market with so many buyers, you know, you want to make sure that it has a good flow and it feels good and people could imagine themselves living and growing in the home. So that's what I kind of do. And when we go out with a photographer, we make sure it looks the absolute best for pictures to get the most activity as soon as we go on the market.
Well, and that is exactly what staging really is. And in the truest form of the world for realtors is setting the house up for showings and for pictures. A lot of people think of staging as I need a bunch of furniture or I need a bunch of stuff, somebody to come in and just bring all this stuff in. And 90% of the time, that's not the case. We work with what's there, but we just help make it better for that purpose. Some other things we wanted to talk about, you know, obviously one of the big things, if you know us pretty well, and a lot of you do, you know, we like to be very involved in the community. We like to spend our time helping out. We like to give back. So there's a couple things just wanted to bring up. First of all, Terry Jo recently became a board member
for the Farragut West Knox Chamber, which is really nice because it gives us an opportunity to be in the know of new businesses, growth of businesses, as well as the town of Farragut and understanding, you know, just everything that's around us. So I've only been in it for 2 months, but it has been really an informative 2 months. And so I've enjoyed it so far. Another item that we have this year so far, mark your calendars, is June 6th, we will be hosting our third annual dragon boat race. We will be in the dragon boat race. So we'll be looking to fill that, get some sponsors, and fundraise. So we will need your help to help us fundraise to help CARM. If you don't know anything about Dragon Boat, this is their CARM's biggest fundraiser of the year. Last year, I think their goal was $220,000. And this year, before signing up, I actually had a meeting with somebody at CARM to know a little bit more about where our money goes when it goes to CARM and kind of how many people they help overall. And then they have quite a few programs. So I will be opening up an opportunity where we can go and tour CARM and get to know a little bit more about them, since they are such a huge participant and help to our community and those in need. So, but that's June 6th. It'll be all day at the Cove at Concord.
It's a lot of fun.
It is a lot of fun. We make it a whole day party, everything like that. So we really would love to have everybody come out. We usually have between 60 and 80 people show up just for our area. Our tent will be right on the water again, just like last year. So we'll be able to see the boats crossing the finish line. We will have a promotional tent for the Knox Fox Real Estate Group, because last year in June, we had not opened up our company when we actually had the race on Saturday. We moved our stuff on Tuesday. So, but we are looking for fantastic, and we always have great sponsors for this, from our t-shirts to our food to our drinks to everything involved. Got some cornhole, the kids come out and play, everything like that.
And we'll definitely be reminding everybody about the Dragon Boat Race. But on that note, something else we're going to do a little different this year, and then we'll wrap it up. You know, in the past, Terry, Joe, and I, it's always been important to us to give back monetarily to, you know, to different charities. But one thing we've thought really hard on this, and one thing we're wanting to do this year is involve you. And how we can involve you is by when you or someone you refer to us uses us to buy or sell a home, we're going to donate 10% of our commission to the charity of your choice. So how that would work is, you know, let's say you decided you wanted to buy or sell, you know, after it closes, 10% of that commission will go to the charity you choose. You know, if you refer us to somebody, most likely you guys are going to have the same, you know, the same circle. You're going to both be involved probably in the same charities or whatever, but essentially we'll donate 10% to that charity. And if you don't have necessarily a favorite charity or somebody, you know, an organization that you are familiar with to donate to, I'm going to start putting out a list of charities that we've come across. We've been doing a lot of stuff with 100 Realtors That Care, 100 Realtors and Affiliates. We have a lot of great affiliates that care.
We do have some great affiliates.
Some great affiliates. But putting that information out there, because if there's one thing Knoxville's awesome about, I mean, we are the volunteers. And there are a lot of great organizations and they all need support. So this is just a great way, I think, for us to really bolster our community along with you.
And that goes along with, if you know anybody who's looking to buy or sell in another state, country, whichever, we can always refer them to a trusted, reputable realtor that we can, obviously we would then...
we would earn a referral commission, yep. And we can donate 10% of that to the charity of your choice. So a lot of great opportunities there. The goal is obviously to give back and to support our community. And, you know, hopefully I'd like to get some feedback. If you have a great charity that you would definitely like us to promote on our page and in some of this communication, reply back. Let us know. So that's two things I'd like to hear from you. Two things I'd like to hear from you. One is goals for this year. And two is what kind of charity would you like to support? And with that being said,
So I just want to thank everyone who has supported us over the last, Eric and I together for almost 6 years, myself for 12 and a half years. I'm still in communication with quite a few of the clients that I worked with 12 years ago. And I just want to thank every one of you for everything you've always done, for thinking about us, for referring us, for supporting us, for your kind words, your love, everything to the sort. Eric and I feel as though we are very blessed and we would not be in this position with our company, with our lives, if it wasn't for each and one of you.
That's the truth. 100%. Well said. All right. Talk to y'all later.
Bye.
Bye.